Hello students, up till now we have discussed about bending stresses and shear stresses. We have solved many examples on bending and shear stresses. Now in that, one part is more important just for general knowledge purpose, that is shear connector. It is asked in many competitive examination, what is shear connector? So shear connector means what? Already we have discussed about the shear stress. Okay, so it is the horizontal shear stress present between the two parts or two moving parts or two different parts. Now here you can see there is a junction, and we have solved many examples where there are two values of tau lies, that is tau 1 and tau 2 at this junction where wave and flange is meeting. But what happens whenever force is acting laterally, horizontally, okay, or even vertically, at that time this particular joint may get displaced or may get felt. Okay, so to avoid failure of such junctions or joints, here we are using shear connector. Okay, so in old days, normally in the wooden structure they are making somewhat extended part, and that extended part is fixed into pole to avoid the movement of this particular joints. But nowadays, due to advanced technology, we are having different connecting members or connecting means. That means we are having bolts, we are having nuts, nut bolts, we are having rivets, we are having quarter pins, we are having welding. Okay, means if you are using these media for the connection to prevent the motion of the bodies, that particular part is called as the connector. Means the things which is used to connect that is called as a connector. But what is the main function of that connector? Is to avoid the shearing. That's why it is called as the shear connector. Okay, here you can see when two or more parts are required to be connected by means of bolt, screws or nails to prevent the relative motion between them, the connectors are called as shear connector. Okay, means there may be longitudinal or lateral shear stress. Okay, so to avoid that movement in lateral direction, if we are using this connector here at the joint, it will not going to move or not going to displace. The longitudinal shear along the shearing surface are registered by shear connector. If there is any movement longitudinally, that particular movement will be registered by shear connector. How to design it? There are few important steps, but before that you must know what is the shear flow. Shear flow means what? In which direction it is going to move. To avoid that, you must use the shear connector. So shear flow is the longitudinal force per unit length transmitted across the section. Okay, so it is the force transmitted across the section. That particular section, how we transmit the shear, depending on that you have to design the shear connector. Okay, means magnitude of shear is very, very important. Okay, you might have observed many steel structures or many structures where normally single bolt is not used. Single bolt can be used, but whenever shear force is very small. Okay, but when these shear connectors are used, they are used in groups. There may be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 10, 20 bolts at a joint depending upon the type of force. Means to find out first of all magnitude of the shear per unit length, we are using the formula SAY bar upon BI or FAY bar upon BI. So that is our shear force formula. Okay, so shear force at each connector, F is equal to horizontal shear into spacing or pitch. Means spacing or pitch means what? Spacing or pitch. Pitch means what? Center to center distance between two bolts. Spacing means what? Same meaning. Center to center distance between two bolts. That distance into shear force. You will get the total shear transmitted by the connector. So shear strength of connector, how it is calculated? It is calculated using shear force at each connector into area. Okay, if you know the shear stress transmitted into area of the bolt, you can find out what is the capacity of that bolt to transmit the force. Okay, means suppose only 100 kN force you have to transmit, no need to provide 10 volts. As the magnitude of shear strength to be transferred is very small, so you should use 1 or 2 volt, that is sufficient to transmit that shear. But if 1000 kN shear force you want to transfer, means 1 and 2 volt is not sufficient. In that case, you must use more number of bolt, otherwise that particular 1 or 2 bolts will fail in shear. Okay, so that's why this connector means not always use bolts. You can use rivets also, you can use small screws also, you can use welding also. In with welding you will get the rigid connection, means after the welding there is no chance of any movement, and that's why the connection obtained by welding is a rigid connection, means it will avoid the shearing between the cross sections. If you want to calculate the force is equal to shear stress into area of connector. Okay, so tau into A, or tau is equal to F upon A. Okay, so by using this formula you can calculate either force, shear stress or area of the connector. So these connectors are used to avoid the shearing. Now, what is the concept of shear force? It measures the shear force per unit length, which is useful in application of built up members. Normally, where the shear connectors are most useful? Whenever section is built up. Built up means what? Built up means it is not made up of single unit. Suppose there is a L section, it is not a single section. Okay, if it is a rolled section which is casted in the factory, you will directly get angle, ready-made angle in the market. But suppose you are not having ready-made angle, then what you will do? We'll take first vertical part and then the horizontal part, means we'll take two plates together and then you will join at the center. Okay, means whenever there are any built-up members, generally we are using the shear connectors. For built-up members, section they are built up and joined together using nails bolts. Shear flow help us to decide the appropriate spacing between nails bolts to ensure the sufficient strength. Means whenever you are attaching two different plates, that shear connector should have sufficient strength. Thin walled members. Sometimes what happen? The member is very very thin. Thin means what? The thickness is not much. Very small thickness. So that particular section may fail due to shearing. Okay. So in that particular case, if we use the shear connector, it will help to increase the strength of that particular thin member. Okay. So in this way, there will be shear flow in the different built up sections, thin walled structures, and these shear force, if we not use the shear connector, there is a chances of failure of the structure due to that tangential shear force. Okay, so shear connector must be considered while calculating the total strength to be transferred by the members. Okay, so this is the information about the shear connector. Thank you very much.